Good day to you all. In this third movie, I want to show you my progress on the Daniel McFarland cook quest I'm building. So both quests are now ready, but you see there is a small difference in the total amount of wiring on the secondary. That is because I noticed in the making the previous video that when I go too high in RPM, I lost some countings of the windings of the primary of this one. So I did it slowly on this one and I came to an amount of 3000 instead of 2860 for the same amount of distance on the pipes. So therefore, because I used a relationship of divided by 3 of the total length of wire for the secondary, I did that also for the second coil I built, but then of course then you had here some more windings. We go more when I show you the measurements. So now we have 3000 windings of the 0.2 millimeter wire and 800 windings of the 1 millimeter wire. Instead of in the first coil, I had 2860 windings and 763 for the secondary. This is gives a relation of 3.74. And now we have a relationship of 3.75. So the only thing I want to remember out of these measurements is my resonance frequency. That was the most important I would like to know, because if I built an interrupter or whatever, then I would like to know what the resonance frequency is. But I don't know if I can go that high with an interrupter, but we shall see. And also what I noticed is that when I used in step-up configuration, so when I used the 800 windings as input and the 3000 windings as output, that the ratio of the two, so in this case the 3.75, when you go higher in frequency, that is not more the case, it is very much more. These measurements were done unloaded with the coils open and the sine wave of the frequency that is stated here. Now if I used the 3000 windings coil as the secondary instead of the primary and we use it as a step up, then we see that we go much higher in the ratio between the two than is normally foreseen when you just calculate it with the with dividing by the windings. That was also the case with the other coil. So you can see here it can go even to up to 10 times the voltage instead of the 3.74. So that's a very big difference. Now, those two things are the only thing that I want of those measurements, because now I have a frequency in mind to build the interrupter or whatever I need. So I came to this one sentence in the patent and I want to analyze it more, because here is stated how to produce or to start the system. So if we look at this, there can be other ways. I can be totally wrong, so please don't follow me. Make your own analyze. But this is what I think about it. So it's stated here that it is while producing or starting. So we can use three different ways. We can use a steel magnet, an electromagnet, or a helix around one of the helixes. So this means that if we take, for example, this one, we can wind a core around it, and we can use a permanent magnet or an electromagnet. But then, of course, we can ask ourselves, how do we need to place that magnet? Does it need to go in that way? So if you have here the coil, then we put it on this, with the north and the south in one direction. Or do we put it on top to the coil, like this, or around. Now, I didn't have a big enough magnet to go around the coils, but I use it only as an example on this picture. So that is how I understand this part. And then he also states, and causing a secondary current in the enclosed helix by means of a battery current in the outer one. So this would mean that we have to make a current running through this coil with a battery. Of course, normally when you have an inductor, you have also the interrupter. This is not yet built. But as I stated before, it's the 65 kilohertz. I want to know what the resonance frequency was, just to have an idea what could be the best frequency. But I don't think I'm gonna make that high. But we shall see. Now, when I look at the possibilities that we have for an electromagnet, then I see that it's the same with the permanent magnet. Only difference is that we need to have a hollow core because it must go around. So when I stated in the sentence on the patent, because I see, while this comma here states and then around, I see it for all, not only for the helix. And I can be wrong in that, so please make your own analysis. Also for the helix is just the same possibilities that we have. Would we put it around the core or do it at a distance and to the coil? So my biggest problem is to find out more about magnetism. So this is another document I'm going to film. You can pause if you want to read it. I can also send it to you by email, it's no problem. So if we look at magnetism, because excuse me, we need to know how to start the system, of course. Then I came to a Joseph Newman book, but there I am not one moment. So here you have the field lines of the magnet like he uses in his books, and I don't really agree with that one. I think it's like this and going in here to the blotch wall and then also over here to the blotch wall. So this is splitted in half instead of one. In my next video I'm going to show you some measurements where you can see why I'm thinking that. But I'm going to need to put a camera on a stand for do the measurements, because I need both hands for that. So that will be in my next movie. So thank you for watching to this one, and hope to see you in the next one. Thank you very much.